So Stochastic Games, originally due to Shapley, have a bunch of different quantities: states, actions, transitions, rewards, and discount factors. And here's how we're going to do it. We're gonna say that S, little S, is one of the states, and actions could be like little A. But actually, since we're going to focus mostly on two-player games for the moment, I'm going to write actions as A and B, where A is an action for player one and B is an action for player two. Sound okay?
Sure.
All right, so next we have the transition function. So the transition function says if you're in some state S and there's some joint action that's taken, like all the players choose their action simultaneously, A comma B, then what's the probability of reaching some next state S prime? And we can write rewards the same way. So there's reward for player one, given that we're in state S and there's a joint action AB. And there's the reward for this at the other player, second player. And the discount factor is, you know, like a discount factor.
Sure, that makes sense. So it's the same discount factor for everyone.
Yes, good point. One need not define things that way, but in fact, that's the way it's always defined.
Hey, not to go off on a tangent here, but sometimes I see MDPs and things like stochastic games defined with the discount factor being a part of the definition and sometimes not. Like it's just a part of the definition of the problem, or sometimes it's a parameter of an algorithm. Which do you prefer? Why have the discount factor actually listed as part of the definition of the game?
I have no justification other than it's nice to have listed the things that might be important as opposed to, you know, working through algorithms for a while and then saying, oh yeah, there's this other number that kind of matters too.
Okay, that's fair. I was just curious.
So one of the things that I actually find really interesting is that this model was laid out by Shapley, one of the, like a former Nobel Prize winner. I guess once you're a Nobel Prize winner, you're a Nobel Prize winner forever.
Yeah,
so Shapley, the Nobel Prize winner. And as we're going to see in a moment, this model is actually a generalization of MDPs, but Shapley published it before Bellman published about MDPs.
Oh, this is pre-Bellman.
So MDPs, to some extent, can be thought of as a narrowing of the definition of a stochastic game.
Huh.
So, all right, let's do a little quiz and see that we really understand the relationship between this model and other things that we've talked about.
Okay.